welcome to Around the Peninsula. I'm Mark J. Dotti, and today we're going to check out a really interesting art exhibit that happens to be in a car dealership. Let's go find out more.
The title of this show is In Motion. And so if you look at all the paintings, there is motion in every single painting and in every single sculpture. And for the reception on the 14th of December, there is going to be a band. There's going to be the jazz trio. There's going to be food and wine from Whole Foods and from Australia Winery. Many people have donated. Wells Fargo has been very generous to us. Schweitzer Learning Center has been very generous, as, of course, Lexus, who's been fabulous. So this reception is from 6 to 9. We're expecting probably 500 people, so if you'd like to be one of the 500 people that come, we have the food. Avalon Gardens will have their drill team perform. They will also have a choir. There's more on the list that will be coming. We're going to have a solo opera singer come. So it's really going to be special. Children, families, it's going to be a wonderful event for the South Bay.
Do you have some work up?
I definitely have two pieces that were accepted, and I feel very honored to be in the show. I do.
Okay, so where did this wild idea come out to have, were an Alexis dealership or Alexis repair shop, to have art here?
It just seemed natural with all the space that we have available. We were involved in an art show prior called Flagstop, and we actually left some of the walls up, which you see, and we've showcased some local talent ever since. And Jody came to me with this idea months ago, and it just seemed like the right thing to do, to let art kind of be in the building, help showcase the building. We're not very good at interior designing, obviously, and this really lights the place up.
And so where are we? What is this facility that we're in right now?
This is the South Bay Lexus Parts and Service Facility. So we repair vehicles and sell parts out of here, not cars. We sell cars out of the Pacific Coast Highway location.
So while somebody's getting their car serviced, they're going to be looking at this art?
There you go. That's part of it.
And is this also open to the general public?
Yes. Anybody can come on down at any point in time. We're open 6 days a week. Look at the art, have a look around, and hopefully find something that they like.
This is Velvet Marshall's piece. It's 8 feet by 8 feet. It's called Bridge Over Troubled Waters, and it's made out of probably oil paint and tar. So it's an incredibly beautiful piece that she has here displayed. This piece is by Nancy Town Schultz. It's called Interiors, and it's a mixed media piece. It's probably 5 feet by 5 feet. And it's really incredibly beautiful. She's a very sophisticated artist from San Pedro, and she has her own studio in the loft. This piece is by Larry Bott. It's called Kevorkian, and it's one of the most clever pieces that we have in the show, and everybody's commented heavily on this. As you can tell by looking at it, it does have a Kevorkian look. Cynthia Joyce is another artist that we feel very honored to have in this art show. Her work is all over the South Bay. She does extremely large pieces, but for this show she did something beautiful called Lemure. Her work is very well known, especially at the Whale Watch Center. She does beautiful whales, and she's a lovely artist and a super person. This sculpture is by Bijan Bijan. It's called Eternity. He is extremely famous, and we feel very lucky to have him in our show. This piece, I know he has it priced for discussion, but anyway, I just wanted you to see it's hand-carved from marble, and if you look him up on the internet, you'll see how famous he really is. This piece is by Bob Francis. It's called Hibiscus, and he is extremely talented and sophisticated, and all of his photographs where he works with a special process that only he knows, and his work is exceptionally valuable. This painting is by Gloria D. Lee. It's called Kaleidoscope. Gloria D. Lee is one of the famous artists from the South Bay. She's taught here for many years up at the Palos Verdes Art Center and in Inglewood. This painting is by Gloria D. Lee. It's called Kaleidoscope. It's a 16 by 20 painting. She uses acrylic and mixed media. She's a very famous artist that's taught in Palos Verdes Art Center and in Inglewood for decades. And she has a studio in San Pedro. This is a piece by Patty Grau called Nuclear Family. It's had a great deal of interest. She's an artist that's been in the South Bay for several decades. Her work is exceptionally creative, and she's had a lot of interest for this particular piece. This photography was made by Phil Earle. It's called Pierce Point Dairy Farm, and it was actually in existence years past. He's a well-known artist. He's in the gallery of the Palos Verdes Art Center in the Promenade 159. He travels all over the United States to find unusual photographs, and this is one of his best. This is another photograph by Phil Earle. It's called the Pierce Point Dairy Farm, another his top photograph. So when you come to visit Lexus, you'll see them together. This huge painting is by Peggy Zask. It's called Founder. It's the most beautiful horse. Peggy and Ben Zask own their own gallery in Palos Verdes in the Promenade. And they have incredible art shows each month. This painting is by Jody Wiggins. It's called Robotic Cat. It's one of my favorite pieces. It was accepted in the Torrance Art Museum last year, and I'm very proud to have it represented here at Lexus.
Let's start with your painting behind us and some of the media that you use and some of the mediums that you use. What are some of your, what's involved?
It started with watercolor, which would be the color areas underneath, and it's a layered painting. So it has collage over it. It has acrylic over the watercolor, so a lot of different mediums. Mm-hmm. And then scratching through, for example, here, it's opaque, but if you scratch through it, then you can see something of what's underneath. So...
And is this kind of the inspiration in the work that you usually do, or is this out of the norm for you?
Pretty much the last, I'd say, 20 years, maybe. I've been working with layering, printmaking, I did before that. So printmaking, watercolor, painting, I do it all.
And how long have you been an artist then?
All my life. So maybe in the last 40 years, really pushing it. But I also teach. And I started out with teaching academics with younger kids. Now I teach older kids. We are, I don't know, 60, 70, 80, 90.
And what do you teach then?
I teach them about painting and creating artwork and how to be who they are.
I started out with realistic, then I went very abstract, and then I found my love starting with an elephant.
So do you paint a lot of elephants?
A lot too. Yeah. Yeah, people love them, I love them. Because they're warm. I think everybody knows that, you know. And
what kind of medium do you use? What are we looking at here?
Acrylic paint. The texture is my texture. And the reason I say that is because you can go to the art stores and buy textures, but I could never afford it. So I had to make up my own. So this was just because I had to figure it out.
And now it's a style of yours.
Now it's my style, yes. And I've tried the stuff you buy in the stores, but I don't, you know, I love what I do. I love the feeling.
So if somebody else is also looking at this and seeing how neat your style is and wants to get more of your work, where would they find that?
You can go to Facebook. I mean, I have a lot of Val Simons, believe it or not, so you got to remember this mug. And then you can go to Artslant Val Simon, okay? It's original, and I can't do it again twice the same way because it's the process and it's a palette knife on, off, mix, 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 mix. And I never know what's going to happen. It's challenging. I've destroyed many easels, but I love it because it makes me part of it.
How long have you been painting and what's your medium of choice?
Well, at the moment, this is oil on canvas, but I also do some printmaking.
So tell me about this painting behind us. What do we have here? Where are we?
Okay, this is in the Ho Rainforest, and we were up there in August. And we've been there a number of times. My husband and I travel together. And the Ho Rainforest is an exceptional place because it's one of the only temperate rainforests on Earth except for in New Zealand. And there, it's amazing the difference.
Where is this? What area?
It's actually in the Olympic Peninsula. And there's not that many people there. So it's weird because I'm so used to California beaches and California coast. And
so is your process? Do you paint there at the spot, or do you take pictures later?
I usually, in cases when I'm traveling like this, I take a lot of pictures, and thank God for digital cameras, because they have, you know, 1,000 pictures can be held in this, you know, little card. You know, it's horrible to run out of film in the middle of nowhere, but now that doesn't happen. So that's great. And I also can play around with the cameras and deal with other issues. You know, you can put filters in and all this stuff so that if I have like glaring light, I can fix that, take a picture of what I'm seeing, and then put a filter in and fix that, you know. So when I bring this home, I have a big group of pictures that will maybe just turn into one painting ultimately.
And what about finding your work? If somebody's really interested in what you do, do you have a website?
And it's karenwickham.art. So that's one way of finding me.
Great. And so these artists were selected, they're juried in? Is that true?
All the artists were juried in, and they're mainly from all of the South Bay, Rancho Palos Verdes, Torrance, some are from Los Angeles. We had a few submissions from Utah and different states. We feel very honored because we have some really high-end artists here. Bijan Bijan is a famous sculpturist, and we're very honored to have his sculptures. We have Velvet Marshall, Gloria Dee Lee. We have another girl, Lily Mueller, and several artists that are well-known in the Los Angeles area.
And what does this all go towards? What's the goal here?
You know, there are three goals, and that's one of the reasons I was so excited to work with this committee. The three goals are for the Schweitzer Learning Center, which they will, it's a fundraiser for them, and they will receive 25% of all the profits. We are so grateful for Lexus, because Lexus has given us this facility, and we're having a huge reception on the 14th of December. For this reception at 6 to 9, it's going to be a fabulous reception. It's free to the public. For anything that sells, of course, the Schweitzer Learning Center will benefit. Everything here is for sale. And also, we know Christmas is around the corner. So we've sort of gone outside the box. And if somebody chooses a painting, they may have it before Christmas. They may purchase it. The obligation of the artist would be to replace the art that would sell with another similar size, so that Lexus will always look like a museum. And if you come and you look at the art, it definitely is all museum quality. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about the Schweitzer Learning Center. It's located in Torrance. It is a school that works with autistic children, or in junior high, high school. Many of the children that come in there are special needs, and every one of those teachers are totally dedicated to helping these young adults become good citizens. And I go to the graduation every year, and I hear story after story, and so many of these young adults have been in foster care. Last year I heard of a man that was in foster care, 43 homes. And when he came in, of course, there were many problems. When he graduated, he's on a scholarship to go to college. And there are a few schools like this. So my heart goes out to the Schweitzer Learning Center. And year after year, decade after decade, Dr. Jan Schweitzer has done so much to help that school. And I feel wonderful that anything we can do to help that school is so important. About 11 months ago, Bill Messenger, who runs South Bay Lexus, came to me and asked me about doing a very large art event. And so it's taken 11 months to create this art event, and a committee was formed. And there's some wonderful people on the committee, Gloria Dee Lee and Valerie Simon, Barbara St. John, Herlinda, and several others that have really helped to put this show together.
Everyone needs to come on down and check it out. The art is fantastic, very professionally done. We're very happy with how this has turned out. Everyone involved with the show has been fantastic, so come and look at it.
So if you're looking for some art that you'll really love, this display will be up until Valentine's Day 2014. For Around the Peninsula, I'm Mark J. Dottie. Mm-hmm.